Hi all, we will continue the analysis of pre-stress to beam with some more examples. The first problem, a pre-stressed concrete beam of cross section 120 mm by 300 mm is pre-stressed by a straight cable carrying effective force of 180 kN at an eccentricity of 50 mm. The beam supports a live load of 3.14 kN per meter. Dead load is 0.864 kN per meter over a span of 6 meters. Estimate the stress at the center of the span. If the modulus of rupture of concrete is 5 N per mm square, evaluate the load factor against cracking. We can do the first part of this problem as in the previous examples. Then starting with that, this is the case B, that means the stress distribution due to the eccentric tendon. If the stress distribution due to eccentric tendon, the stress at the top fiber can be calculated by using the equation P by A minus PE by Z plus MB by Z plus ML by Z. And the stress at the bottom fiber is P by A plus PE by Z minus MD by Z minus ML by Z that we have discussed in the previous lecture. In order to find out the stress at the top fiber and the bottom fiber, we need to determine the terms P by A, PE by Z, MD by Z and ML by Z. Then firstly P by A, where P is the pre-stressing force and A is the area of cross-section. Then in the question, pre-stressing force is given as 180 kN and the area of cross-section can be calculated by using 120 into 300. Therefore, A is equal to 0.036 m square. Therefore, P by A can be calculated as 5 N per mm square. We got the first term P by A in both the equation. And the second term is PE by Z. You know the value of P, that is 180 kN, and E means that is eccentricity. Eccentricity is given as 50 mm. And the next term is Z. Since it is a rectangular cross section, Z can be calculated by using BD square by 6, that means 120 into 300 square by 6. For Z is equal to 18 into 10 raised to 5 mm cube. E is 50 and P is equal to 180 kN. From these values, we can calculate the second term, that is PE by Z, as 5 N per mm square. And the third term is MD by Z. You know the value of Z. The next is MD. MD means a simply supported beam subjected to UDL. The maximum moment is WL square by 8. WL, that is WD. WD, that means the dead load, that is given in the question as 0.864 kN per meter into L square by 8. Then you got the value of MD by Z as 2.16 MPa or 2.16 N per mm square. Similarly, you can calculate ML by Z also. ML is equal to WL into L square by 8. WL is given in the question as 3.14 kN per meter. For you will get a value of ML by Z as 7.85 MPa. So in this equation, you got all the four values in both the equations. So substitute all these four values in these equations. You will get the stress at the top fiber as 10.01 MPa and the stress at the bottom fiber is approximately equal to 0 MPa. Then in the question, there is a second part. The second part is you have to find out the load factor. Then in that case, they have mentioned, estimate the stress at the center of the span that we have calculated. Then if the modulus of rupture of concrete is 5 N per mm square, evaluate the load factor against cracking. When the cracking occurs, that means an additional moment which leads to crack developed is developed there. That additional moment can be calculated by using the equation M is equal to Fz, where F is the stress leads to cracking, that means modulus of rupture. For F is given as 5 MPa in the question. In the question, F is given as 5 Newton per mm square, and you know the value of Z, so you can calculate the extra moment needed for rupture. Okay. Then actually the main thing, that is, you have to find out what is the value of load factor. You know the equation for load factor S is equal to cracking moment divided by working moment. The working moment is same as ML plus MD. But in the case of cracking moment, there is an additional moment. That additional moment, we got the value, that is 9 kilonewton meter. So in the cracking moment is ML plus MD plus that additional moment, and working moment is ML plus MD. So you will get the value of load factor as 1.5. Okay. The next question is, an asymmetrical I-section beam is used to support a live load of 2 kN per meter over a span of 8 meters. Effective pre-stressing force of 100 kN is applied at 50 mm from the soffit of the beam. Estimate the stresses at the center of span for the following condition. The first one, pre-stress plus self-weight, that means there is no need to consider the live load. And the second case, pre-stress plus self-weight plus live load. Okay. The main difference of this problem with the previous examples is that this cross-section is an asymmetrical I-section B. If the section is an asymmetrical section, that means we have to consider, in the equation, for calculating the section modulus, in the equation, Z is equal to I by Y. If the section is symmetrical, I and Y, that is same for top and bottom fiber. But if the section is unsymmetrical, you have to find out Y top and Y bottom separately. Okay. Then for calculating Y top and Y bottom, and also for calculating the value of moment of inertia about X axis, firstly we have to find out the center of gravity. The center of gravity can be calculated by using the equation Y bar is equal to A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 plus A3 Y3 divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3. Then for this section, this part is the first part, second part and third part. A1 means 100 into 60 into Y1 means the center of gravity of, centroid of the first portion from the bottom. Reference axis is bottom axis. That means 60 by 2, that is 30. That's why 30 here. Then A2 Y2, that means for the second portion, area is 80 into 280. And the centroid of the second portion from the bottom is 280 by 2 plus 60, that is 200. Similarly, A3 can be calculated by 300 into 60. And this Y3 means centroid of the third portion to the bottom. That means 60 by 2 plus 280 plus 60. Then A1 plus A2 plus A3. Y bar means 244 mm. That means that is the reference axis is bottom axis. That means centroid will be at the distance of 244 mm from the bottom axis. Then from the top axis, it will be 400 minus 244. 400 means the total height. 400 minus 244, that is 156. The centroid, from the bottom it is 244 mm and from the top is 156 mm. So you got the value of Y top as well as Y bottom. The next is, what is the value of I? Since it is an asymmetrical section, you have to use the parallax theorem. The parallax theorem means IGXS, that means the centroid of the considering portion. the moment of inertia about the centroid of the considering portion plus A1 H1 square. A1 means area of that considering portion. H1 means the distance between the centroid of the considering portion to the centroid of the whole section. And by using this parallaxis theorem, you will get the value of I like this. When you got the value of I, Y top and Y bottom, from this you can calculate Z top and Z bottom by using the equation Z is equal to I by Y. Then go to the problem. The first case is you have to find out the stress at the midspan for the case pre-stressing force plus self-weight. That means you are considering only pre-stressing force and self-weight. No need to consider the live load. In that case, the equation will be like this. Stress at top is equal to P by A minus PE by Z top plus MD by Z top. Stress at the bottom means P by A plus PE by Z bottom minus MD by Z bottom. Okay, then first term is P by A. Pre-stressing force is known. Pre-stressing force is, that is 100 kN. A means A1 plus A2 plus A3. The P by A will be 2.155. In both the cases, it will be 2.155. The next term is PE by Z. These two terms are different since ZT and ZB. PE by ZT, PE by ZB. You know the value of P, you know the value of eccentricity. Then how will you get the value of eccentricity? The centroid of the whole portion that you know and the pre-stress in the given question, the pre-stressing force 100 kN is applied at 50 mm from the soffit of the beam. That means 50 mm from the bottom of the beam. The pre-stressing force is acting at 50 mm from the bottom of the beam and center of gravity of the whole section is acting at 244 from the bottom of the beam. Therefore, the distance between that two, that will be the eccentricity E. That E is 194. That means you know the value of P, E and Z top and Z bottom, then you can calculate what is the value of PE by Z in both the cases. The next is MD by Z. MD means, you know, that is WL square by 8 and WD, that means dead load can be calculated by using the equation gamma into A, that is 24 into the area, that the area means area of the whole section A1 plus A2 plus A3. That means you have, then you will get the WD is equal to 24 into 0.0464, WL square by 8, that is MD. By knowing the value of MD, you can calculate what is MD by ZT and MD by ZB. Then substitute all these values, then you will get the stress at the top fiber, that is equal to 0, and the stress at the bottom fiber, that is equal to 5.535 Newton per mm square. And the second case, that B. In that case, there is only one difference. That means you have to consider the live load also. Pre-stress condition is pre-stress plus self-weight plus live load. In that case, you know the other terms. P by A, you know. P by Z, you know. MD by Z, you know. The only thing you have to find out ML by Z top and ML by Z bottom also. Then ML means WL square by 8, WL, that is 2 kN per meter is given in the question. Then you can find out what is ML by ZB and ML by ZT. Then substitute all the values here. Then you will get stress at the top is equal to 3.289 Newton per mm square. And stress at the bottom is equal to 0.381 Newton per mm square. Okay. Thank you.